new intro. So much love and appreciation to those of you who have been with me for the 2 year period plus that I've been doing this. Thank you for showing your love and support to the channel. And to anybody else who is brand new to the platform and you would like to support the channel, also you can do it by way of Patreon, Anchor, the clothing store, and also the shoe shop that is listed in the comment description below. And again, thank you to any and all of you guys who have been here to support this channel during the 2+ year period. I wouldn't be able to do what I do every single day without you. Before this video gets started, ask yourself this question. Where is the Asian American community and the Pacific Islanders to speak out against these acts that one of their own proceeded to do in a predominantly black city where he chose to actually police? And where are all of the other news anchors and the social media Asian American warriors who always wanted to speak out on Stop the Asian Hate? Where are they to specifically speak out against what it is that one of their own did when he targeted, specifically targeted, black men in Detroit?
Hear me clearly. America is not a racist country.
We need to adjust. Well, first of all, no, I don't think America is a racist country.
Join the force. Officer Stephen Koo has repeatedly been accused of excessive force and using hostile and racist language. He's also accused of harassing people of color who say their biggest crime was being in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Seven investigator Ross Jones joins us now with what he's learned.
It's a story you'll see only here on Seven.
Being myself an African American, I don't put much stock into the police force anymore. I started opening my door to step out of my vehicle, and that's when the cop car came blazing up on me. He told me not to move, asked me where the drugs are. Are there drugs in my vehicle? Are there drugs in the house that I'm approaching? What am I doing here? And said, no, sir, I do not know what's going on. I'm just here to check on some rental property. Still holding a gun on you after 3 minutes, 4 minutes. And I'm asking you, pleading with you, can you please lower your weapon? He just said, he's just another stupid n-.
Do you have any doubt at all that he used the N-word?
I have no doubt in my mind that he used the N-word. If you feel that strongly about the color of my skin, you probably shouldn't be an officer in the city of Detroit.
They rolled the window down and they asked us, do we have any guns or drugs on them? We said no. They told us to lift up our shirts and do a complete circle so they could see our waistband. We complied. Thank my dumb brother that I'm going to jail.
He used that word?
Yes. He said it like that's something that he always says. He was very confident in saying it.
And Reed's neighbor was a witness.
And he was like, this is because of your brother. And I was like, whoa, man, hold on, wait a minute.
We take it very seriously, and we have disciplined members of the department strenuously when using that type of language, especially with citizens.
Not him, though.
Not in 2015, apparently. However, I can't state with confidence what occurred at that hearing when he appealed it.
They pay no attention to any of this officer's patterns of practice, despite the remarkable similarity between all of these people's complaints.
Julie Hurwitz is a civil rights attorney currently suing Koo in federal court on behalf of a Detroit man Koo and his partners arrested. She has reviewed his lengthy list of citizen complaints dating back more than a decade. Sergeant Stephen Koo. As we reported last week, the 12-year veteran of the Detroit Police Department has amassed more complaints against him than almost any other officer on the force.
What the heck is going on here? Why is this man still a police officer?
Stuff like that, you just know that your best intentions is not to protect people like me. You don't like people like me.
He a gangster with a bad. I ain't never seen no evil like that. They asked me, can they search me? I said no. I haven't did nothing, you know.
According to Collins' complaint, the two men traded insults before Koo cuffed him and then said,
my trigger finger is itching. I dare you to move. I dare you to move.
What does that mean to you?
Blow my head off. I never had no police threaten my life. He threatened my life.
Should he be a cop today?
Absolutely not. No. He should not be a Detroit police officer.
He should not be an officer of any police department.
Koo and other officers were deemed untruthful. The entire drug case was dismissed, and the disciplinary sergeant recommended Koo be terminated. But instead of doling out any punishment at all, his commanding officer dismissed the entire case for timeliness, saying it had dragged on for too long.
Now I'd like to make a motion to approve the promotions to the rank of sergeant.
Just 3 months later, after a recommendation to fire him.
Those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, motion carried.
Stephen Koo was promoted from officer to sergeant. In his 12 years with the department, Koo has been among its most sued officers, too, amassing at least 8 lawsuits filed against him, costing taxpayers to defend and often settle. The cases run the gamut, from alleged assault and battery to deprivation of civil rights to gross negligence. In each of the lawsuits, Koo was just one of several DPD officers named.
He was trying to antagonize me, trying to give him my paperwork. They didn't want to receive it. Handcuffed me, took me in, booked me.
Their job is to protect and serve, not abuse.
No.
You just live next to the raid.
Right.
They had guns to our head, tell us to get on the ground, shut the up. We ain't, you know, got no right to talk, any of that.
They jumped out cussing, and people took off running. Really just heard the car, and instantly a few people started running. So instantly my reaction was to run. As soon as I started running, I heard somebody say, I'm gonna shoot you. So I really started running fast. Then I woke up in the room. They just kept trying to make me say I had a gun. And just trying to force me to say, you know? And that's what happened that night, you know?
Did you have a gun that night?
No, sir.
Every eyewitness testified, stated unequivocally, he had his hands in the air, they didn't see a gun, there was nothing in his hand.
It's like a gang in itself. I'm more scared of them than I am of actual any gangs that's out there in Detroit. That's who I'm scared of.
Interim Chief James White has taken Koo off the street and is personally reviewing all of the 85 complaints against him and why some were dismissed.
I am concerned. And I'm absolutely disappointed in some of the findings.
So this is my question. Where is the Asian community when it deals with one of their own that specifically chose out of all the places in Michigan that he could decide to be a police officer? He specifically chose to be a part of the Detroit Police Department. Now, this minority, this person of color, did not specifically set out to do his job as a police officer. He specifically set out to do the job to harass black people, to antagonize black people, to disrupt and to cause many of issues to black people and also within the black community. He was specifically sent there and took that job as part of the DPD to spread fear among people in the black community. In a lot of the stories that you were able to hear, he provoked them. He tried to state, oh, hey, I need you to stop for a minute. You know, where's the drugs? Where's this? Where's that? What specifically am I dealing with here? I was called here to this situation. Now, within that, he's fishing. Within that situation, he's trying to cause so much confusion in a short period of time that he thinks that he's going to trick somebody into stating or talking or referring to an illegal activity, thereby giving themselves up, making his job easier. But clearly, that was not the case. He happened upon a black man who wasn't doing anything at all. Just like he happened upon another black man who ended up having his legally obtained firearm and he placed it directly on the porch. This model citizen and one of his boys proceeded to arrest and more than likely abuse that elderly black man who's a part of the black community. A stand-up guy, I may add, because I will note again, he had a legally procured firearm. He had the paperwork and all the identification for it, but even within the story, you heard that this model citizen didn't want to hear any of that information because he knew he had the right guy. He knew that this firearm was not legally registered. And the other thing that I will say to a lot of people is that you will have some individuals that will step up and say, oh, well, you can't say all police. Well, this is a bad incident, but this happens to everybody. It's not just a black issue. This happened in Detroit. So it is a black issue. So you can kindly step down. To the rest of the people that want to say, oh, well, not all officers. And well, explain to me, why is it that his partners who know the law, who took an oath, who know right from wrong, decided to still allow this model citizen to still conduct a wrongful search, who was still able to wrongfully arrest and place bogus charges upon these black men trying to hem them up in the system. And then on top of that, he's had a multitude of lawsuits. He's had a multitude of issues that have been reported, but yet they just disappeared, or they were dismissed, or they were overlooked. And all of this transpired with the board knowing this and still proceeding to upgrade his status on the police force. But you're going to tell me not all officers, and you can't just blame everybody for one bad apple? Well, the problem with that is, if you have a bad piece of fruit and it's moldy, has that white mold or that black mold directly on it, and it happens to spread that mold. Because I'm not sure if people who use that terminology really understand that apples have a very thin skin. It's not thick like an orange. It's not thick like some type of larger fruit. It's a very thin skin. So once that fruit is infected, that means pretty much all the rest of those fruits are infected as well. Even if you can't see it microscopically, you will see that the spores from that mold has attached itself to the other healthy fruit that is around, therefore infecting it. And only in a matter of time or days will you start to see the results of those spores and how they spread amongst the other healthy fruit. So, like I said before, if you know that you have one moldy piece of fruit, why risk the chance of getting ill or potentially dying by trying to ingest other pieces that look healthy that were right next to it? You got to throw the whole thing away. Just like with this police force, you got to throw the whole thing away. But the problem with that is the system isn't going to allow that to take place. And even if you throw away all of the rotten fruit, you still have a basket that carries those spores, which can then in turn, within a matter of time, infect fresh fruit that will be thrown directly back into that basket. So not only do you have to throw away the fruit and the healthy fruit, but you need to throw away the basket as well, which means for the DPD, you need to throw away all of the officers on top of the whole building as well and start from anew. But like I said before, the system would never allow something like that, because this is the way that the system likes to work. This is the way that the system likes to manage. And this system is able to get the numbers that they need to get in order to facilitate black bodies into the privatized jail and prison system, which then allows those individuals to get money off of those black bodies, which then the police more than likely gets kickbacks for. Everything is all tied in. So if you destroy one thing, which will be the DPD and the building that houses it, you also affect the prison system, which then affects money. And they're not going to allow that to happen. But anyways, let me know what you guys think about this video and everything that I stated in the comment description below. And as always, peace, love, and stay tuned for the next video.